Hello, indie game fans. It's trivia time here at I Dream of Indie. Welcome back, or if it's your first time here at the channel, I am Ole Gamer Joe here with another review for you today. Consider hitting that subscribe button for tons of indie reviews and previews of lesser-known games all the way up to AA niche titles. Today, we're looking at Papa's Quiz on the Steam PC platform, releasing as of December 28th of 2020. Developed and published by Old Apes, it is also available on the App Store, and it will be coming to the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. I don't have the dates of those releases just yet, and I don't have the price on Steam at the time of this review either, though I can tell you on the App Store it is priced at $2.99. Papa's Quiz is a trivia-style game for up to 8 players, following a similar trend to the Jackbox series of games, where you can use your mobile device to hop right in and join the action. You can have up to 8 players, and you'll do this by either a room code, or if you are locally playing the game, you can actually scan a QR code and hop into the action that way, but it doesn't really matter. At any rate, however you end up joining the game, you can customize your character in a few different ways. You can change their hair or the look of their faces, and kind of tweak the clothing that they're wearing, and also give them very strange names like Tiny Cat or Tiny Love. From there, you'll find yourself on a trivia show that, as Silent Sign said while we were playing, looks like it's straight out of hell. If hell were video games, this would be the presentation. But at any rate, there is some fun trivia to be had here. I was almost reminded of the Buzz series, which I really enjoyed back on the PlayStation 2 and the PlayStation 3. You'll be greeted with such trivia categories as the Bible, tennis, astronomy, and even Pokemon. There's generally a junior category with easier questions for people to answer, and the way that you choose a category is pretty weird in this game. You'll actually mash on a direction on your phone. If the arrow stays on one category box for long enough, that's the category that you'll be taking on. So I think this would be more interesting with 8 players, and I do intend to test this out in a streaming environment to see if we can get some folks to play along. But for the most part, it's just kind of a tug of war of trying to get the category that you want. The questions can seem a little bit all over the place, so this is more of a general trivia, but there did seem to be a little bit of a lean towards pop culture, which I personally didn't mind. I like pop culture style trivia, and that's probably what I excel at. I'm not the best trivia player in the world, but still, I found that the categories were interesting and diverse, and for the most part, had entertaining questions. Papa's Quiz will also often offer visual clues for you to pick up on, and sometimes even little puzzles that will slowly unveil themselves, and the quickest finger will get the most points. The game is broken up into rounds, and should you win a given round, you will get to perform a victory dance. These dances include the banana bounce, the running rave, and the howling hips, just to name a few. They mostly act as a form of celebration and to taunt your opponents. According to the developer's official website, there are 3,000 questions in this game in total, which is a little bit confusing because if you click another part of the website, it says there are 2,500 questions. I can tell you that I did see a few repeat categories in my time with the game. I don't exactly know what to tell you here because the developer tells you two different things, but anywhere between 2,500 and 3,000 questions seems to be the answer here. All in all though, Papa's Quiz works. I mean, you can join a room, it wasn't any issue at all, and I think that the trivia is decent. It won't speak to every trivia buff out there, but there are some interesting categories and fun questions to be answered. On to that presentation though, which is definitely the strangest and probably the weakest point of Papa's Quiz. I think they're going for a Buzz-style presentation here again, but it really falls flat. All of the characters are almost disturbing looking and very odd, and they have these robotic voices. I don't even know if these are voice actors per se. It sounds like they've typed in the text into a robot and then the robot is reading out that text, and it just all really falls flat. To the game's credit though, I will say that the images look pretty nice. There's good clear visual representation on the screen when you're answering these questions, and the questions are well written enough, so it kind of is a stark contrast to the hosts of this game, which have those robotic voices and really take you out of the experience and just kind of weirded me out. There's also not many phrases from said hosts. They were repeating the same dialogue pretty early on, and that can get a little bit irritating, so yeah, not the best visual presentation going on with Papa's Quiz, but thankfully the trivia is strong enough where you might be able to look past the whole weird aesthetic. Strange voice acting aside, how is the rest of the soundtrack and sound design? Really nothing to write home about here. You have your standard quiz-style music playing in the background. It's suitable. You do get a few interesting tracks when you do your dances, which I thought was kind of a nice touch, but on the whole, there's nothing too memorable about the sound of this game, except for the voice acting, which is memorable perhaps for the wrong reasons. But still, at the end of the day, I think Papa's Quiz is a decent trivia game. There is some fun to be had. I think if you can fill the room with 8 players, you could do a lot worse. I enjoy trivia, so this gets the job done in a lot of ways. There's some weird and interesting questions, a very strange visual design to this game, and unusual music, and an overall aesthetic that might turn some players off, but the trivia is decent, and overall, I didn't have a bad time with this one.
Tiny Cat, you got the most points. Celebrate with a dance. Best dance ever. It's time to choose a new category.
Tap the buttons to move the arrow.
Tap, tap, tap to choose a category.
So what do you think, trivia buffs? Will you be checking out Papa's Quiz? Let us know in the comments section below. And if you have enjoyed our video coverage today, consider hitting that subscribe button. It helps us to bring a voice to the voiceless ones in gaming. There are a ton of other ways to support I Dream of Indie right down in the description box below. That includes our merchandise store, our Discord, or even becoming a member of the channel. But however you end up supporting us, it really means the world, and we thank you so much.
Press a button when you know what the picture is.
The picture is revealed bit by bit.